We welcome them back to the Bowers Mansion Music Festival. Please make them feel welcome. The Sonoran Dogs, everybody. There's a song from our, it's a title cut from our last album, The Navajo Rug, owned by Tom Russell and Ian Tyson. Well, it's two eggs up on whiskey toast, home fries on the side. Wash it down with Roadhouse coffee, that'll burn up your inside. It's just a little Cave Creek, Arizona diner, and her waitress I did love. We set out back, these are old stuff there, the worn out Navajo rug. Aye, 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 Katie, shades of red and blue. Aye, 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 Katie, whatever became of that Navajo rug and you? Jack the boss, he left at six. Miss Katie barred the door. Yeah, she pulled down that Navajo rug and spread it across the floor. I saw lightning across the Catalinas, and I heard the wolf, the turtle dove, lying there next to Katie on that old Navajo rug. Aye, 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 Katie, shades of red and blue. Whatever became of that Navajo rug and you? Last saw old Jack about a year ago. He said the place burned to the ground, and all he said was an old bear tooth. And Katie, she left town. Oh, Katie got a souvenir too, he said as he spit out a tobacco plug. Yeah, you should have seen her run into the smoke, dragging that Navajo rug. Aye, 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 Katie, shades of red and blue. Aye, 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 Katie, whatever became of that Navajo rug and you? So whenever I cross the sacred mountains and the lightning strikes above, it always takes me back in time to my long lost Katie love. But everything keeps on changing and everybody's on the go. You don't find things that last anymore like a double hole in Navajo. Aye, 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 Katie, shades of red and blue. Aye, 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 Katie, whatever became of that Navajo rug and you? Katie, shades of red and blue. Aye, 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 Katie, whatever became of that Navajo rug and you?
Oh, thank you. How's everybody doing? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Thanks for coming out.
It looks a little smoky out there. I can't see y'all. I don't know.
Is it always this smoky? No, we appreciate each and every one of you being out there today. It isn't a bad day. And the dogs are certainly so proud to be here once again. As you've noticed, we have a different banjo player today. We fired Tyler. He's just too fast, too young, too hyper. He quit taking his meds. We just couldn't keep up with him. So he's out playing with another band this weekend. So we grabbed up the next best thing we could find in Arizona. That's Mr. Dick Brown. Dick Brown, give him a wave. Dick was kind enough to join us down in Australia a couple of years ago, so we dusted him off. See if he remembered anything.
Well, I'm working on that. I just wondered, does anybody have a chain out there with it? I was thinking about trying to chain myself just so I don't get blown off the stage.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I've shown my slip a few times. So.
Oh.
Dick Brown sing one for you. We're calling Malone.
From old Ireland and home, and those hills lush and green were a part of my dreams when I dreamed of my Pauline alone. On the day I returned to my sorrow, harbor, the angels had carried her away to a grave on the hill overlooking Mayville. That's where she is sleeping. And her heart was as pure as a dove. For the rest of my life, I will not take a wife. I'll live in this valley alone, planting flowers around in the soft, gentle ground that's holding my calling below. As the soft breezes blow through the meadow, I go past the mill.
Tyler who? Paul, could we possibly have a little more guitar and a monitor, please?
Hey, Pete's
playing tired today, I think.
You notice the size of my shoes? I only wear a 10.
Oh, yeah.
Tyler wears a 16,
yeah,
so it's kind of hard to fill those shoes, you know?
Yeah.
Tyler said to say hello to you, although he's over in Wyoming this week.
Wyoming, yeah. I said Montana. I keep saying he's in Montana.
He's in Wyoming, Montana.
You're in Montana, Wyoming.
No, yeah, right across the border. Here's a song I wrote last about a year and a half ago when I heard John Prine. John Prine had passed away on April 7th, 2020. And I was kind of devastated that night. I got out a bottle of tequila and drank most of it down, I think. It wasn't a big bottle, but John meant a lot to me. I got to meet him at the Bluebird Cafe in Nashville and then a couple times later at Hardly Strictly Festival over in San Francisco. But he bought me a beer at the Bluebird Cafe during our intermission when he came to hear us play. And I was with Lori Lewis and we talked for a while and I told him how much I admired his songs and he was a real influence. So here's a song I wrote for John Prine, and it's about drinking. Because the same day he passed away, I heard that liquor sales were through the roof because of COVID. But it's just about what we've been going through this last year and a half. I'm stuck here at home, so lonesome and blue, playing music with friends is long overdue. I picked my guitar, the tears filled my eyes with news of this virus that's changed all our lives. I think of those times when we met face to face, with a shake of our hands or a long warm embrace. When will we get back to the way things have been? I'm at the virtual honky-tonk, drinking whiskey and gin. And I don't often drink when I'm all by myself. But with COVID-19, I reach for my liquor shelf. I'll uncork another bottle, and I'll drink to my friends. I hope to get back to work when this pandemic ends. Nothing to lose. And I don't often drink when I'm all by myself. But with COVID-19, I reach for my liquor shelf. I'll uncork another bottle, I'll drink to my friends. Hope to get back on stage when this pandemic ends. Yeah, I'll crack another bottle, raise a glass to John Prine, with pure agave tequila or the finest red wine.
And you're back on the
Peter
stage.
McLaughlin, good job, man.
I got to tell you something about Peter. Well, Peter is a city planner in Tucson, Arizona, and he's working from home now because of the COVID thing and everything. And for about the last year and a half, he's written more songs than he's ever written. And there's some kind of a correlation there with him working at home and writing more songs. I wonder if his boss knows about that.
Yeah, paid to write that song.
Yeah, it just seems like... I don't know if he's getting any work done at work.
I don't know. Have you seen their streets? I don't think he is.
Oh, yeah. He's the one that's responsible for the potholes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I put his name on every one of them that I drove through. This is Peter McLaughlin's fault. So.
It's asphalt.
Sorry. It's asphalt? Yeah, same thing. Asphalt. That's your new nickname, asphalt.
You got
got years and years ago from a good friend of mine, Alan Mundy. He and I actually started off back in 1965 from the same banjo teacher, Gary Price. Of course, I told him 10 years later, I said, yeah, but you practiced.
Yeah.
I didn't.
He paid his teacher more than you did.
Anyways, one I got from him called Look Down That Long, Lonesome Road. One, two, three.
One song. At least you learned one. Very good. Well, this next one, if you've been here while we play, you've heard it many times. Became a quick favorite song of ours. We went down to Australia several times over the last 10 years and we stole a song and brought it back. A gentleman named Scott Collins that's on the coast there between Sydney and Brisbane wrote this song. He jumped up on stage with us one night and we played it. So like I said, we did the right thing and just stole it, brought it back to America. We've had a lot of fun with it. It's a good song. It's actually a song about addiction, but it's a happy song, so nobody dies, at least we don't think. Here. Little song called Rosewood.
Up and yells my name.
to take it from his hand. Thunder roars and lightning lights away. Hold me closer, it's getting colder. This chaos is killing me. Let's drive south, babe. Dice are spinning round when they hit the ground. Hold me closer, it's getting colder. This chaos is killing me. Let's drive south, babe. Start over. This might be the death.
Thank you. Thanks, Scott.
We want to thank the finest sound man west of the Pecos, right there, Paul Knight, running sound. You always know if Paul's running the sound, doesn't matter how windy it is, doesn't matter how smoky it is, it doesn't matter if you brought your A game, he's going to make it sound as good as you possibly can.
That's right. If you suck, it's not him.
Not at all.
I think that's his motto on the side of his trailer. If you suck, it's not my fault.
Yeah.
Something like that. I
don't. Yeah, thanks, Paul. It's great to see you. I also want to thank Rick Sparks for loaning me this guitar, because I flew in from Montana this morning, and there wasn't even room for my guitar on the plane, so I couldn't bring it. It was a little tiny plane. So I'm getting to use Rick's Martin here, which is fine with me. It's a little lower action than I'm used to, but that's all right.
I want to thank Karen for using her bass. She loaned me her bass. It's got 5 strings on it. This is like playing a Ferrari or something. Wow. My bass is an old King bass, 1959. We usually put it under the car when we change oil and stuff like that.
Ferrari.
I can barely put the foot down on this and it goes crazy. It's
Anyway, we're just glad to be here at the festival. We always look forward to being here. And we missed last year, but this is a good makeup game right here. We'll have CDs at the table back there. Feel free to stop by. I've got to head right back to the airport to fly back to Montana immediately after the show, so hit us soon right after the show if you want
to
see.
Yeah, the whole band has to just abandon when we get off stage. Sorry, too, but yeah,
so if you do, if you do want a CD, get it quick.
I'm going to hurry up and get back there because I've lost mine. So. Okay, all
right. You want to do the best thing?
I think we're gonna get Pete to sing one he wrote with Brinkman.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I co-wrote this with Brink. It's a song about songwriting, which he does a lot of. He's a prolific songwriter. And it's just about leaving your songs behind for people to sing. around a campfire or along the banks of a river or wherever you can take the songs to, outdoorsy places. And we came up with this one called Footprints in a Song.
Let me kick it?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3.
Songs of rough and rocky trails, midnight boxcars on the rails, songs of stormy seas I've sailed, dreary days and dingy jails, songs of rivers I have run, love that scambles lost and won, of drinking days in barroom halls, Apache wars and canyon walls. Heart to heart, line by line, step by step, rhyme by rhyme, words left behind, sing along, I'll leave my footprints in the song. Words come hard, mountaintops and battle scars, joys and troubles all mine, when melodies and words entwine. Heart to heart, line by line, step by step, rhyme by rhyme, words left behind, sing along, footprints in a song. Song for mother she inspired, one for dad who I admire, for friends and family I adore, songs that ring forevermore. Heart to heart, line by line, step by step, rhyme by rhyme, words left behind, sing along, I'll leave my footprints in a song.
Footprints in a Song. Thank you very much. It's the first time we've done that, I think. Maybe. Here, anyway.
I say we get Mr. Brown to sing another one.
Yeah, same one.
Do that one you wrote in prison.
I wrote several because I had a lot of time.
Well, do the good one. Do the good one.
Well, I guess that's what I call it. Doing my time, yeah. Actually, this is an old Flatten Strokes tune. On this old hop,
do my time. Gotta do my time. With an aching heart and a worried mind.
Tell Tyler, or am I going to tell him
that he still has a job?
Yeah, yes,
okay. I'll call him and tell him. That's right. Yes, I'll do that.
Best thing. Okay. Best thing.
Well, here comes a hurricane. Where's that chain? Just take the banjo out of my hand before I fall off the stage.
Okay.
Would you?
Yeah.
It's worth more than I am. That's.
Here's the best thing.
Son, you can keep it up and do right. grass sure is green in the yard. But what good is all that knowing? The best thing I had going is
great to be back here. We want to thank everyone at the Northern Nevada Bluegrass Association. It's great to see old friends here and get back up here. It wasn't quite this hazy last time we were here, but we're still having fun.
Oh yeah. It's a good time.
I can feel it in my eyes and my throat and all my other vital organs, so.
Ew.
Songwriting material for you.
It is. Write a song about it.
All right.
There's smoke is in your eyes.
Yeah, that's right. There's already a song.
Smoke is in your eyes.
And your throat and your nose. Or your shoes.
Hey, oh, there's another one too.
That'll be in our next album. Thank you very much.
What a teaser.
All right.
I'll hurt myself.
Okay. Is that an Earl song?
Yeah.
Okay. Dick Brown's turning the page on the Earl Scruggs songbook here. And he's going to do one called Pike County Breakdown.
Thank you.
Nice, man. That Ben Gay really works.
This is a song my dad wrote. We'll do since I just did this trip from Arizona up to Montana. Took a 6-day road trip last week up through from Tucson up through northern New Mexico and the San Juan Mountains, Colorado. Climbed a 14,000 foot peak, and I was hurting the next day, but it felt pretty good. Will, you get to be my age.
Thought he was.
It was Handy's peak. It's just barely over 14,000. I think it's 14,028, but it still counts. It's in the books.
The 28 killed you, didn't it?
Yeah, that last 28 was the worst.
Well, thank goodness that's what they make helicopters for.
Helicopters?
This one's called So Long, Arizona. Sweet Clementine, I'll be riding back there on my trusty old mare through the pinyon pine. And just before dawn, gotta keep moving on, how the moon it does shine. Through the high ponderosa, I'll be preciosa, my sweet Clementine.
Thank you.
job, Pete.
Do a song about the train. It's one that we learned from Balsam Range, and Mark does a fine job singing it. Trains don't run everywhere like they used to. So it's not like it is over in Europe where you can catch a train to just about anywhere. But, this one's a little history lesson about transportation.
But it's a happy song. Didn't I already say that?
Last train to Kitty Hawk.
Thank you.
wish you'd just move north with me, so I'm not at a loss. Maybe I'll ask her to go to Alaska to watch the Aurora Borealis.
Yep.
But for now I'm heading south to see Alice in Nogales. When I get there, I'll stroke her hair, I'll whisper in her ear, I'll take her out to dinner, we'll dance and drink some beer. I'd walk all the way from Reno, maybe even Dallas, for just a chance to get to see Alice in Nogales. I'll see Alice in Nogales on Friday night, a-hugging and a-kissing and squeezing with all our might. I know it's wrong to feel this way, I hope it don't sound callous, but I don't feel like doing nothing except see Alice in Nogales. Her down in the barrio. Her father said, don't bother, yet how our love did grow. Well, I might be late when I pass the gate, get searched by federales, but that's okay, I'll go anyway, see Alice in Nogales. I'll see Alice in Nogales on Friday night. I'll bring this guitar with me, we'll sing till broad daylight. Whenever she's right by my side, my heart needs digitalis. But I don't care, I'll still go there to see Alice in Nogales. Yes, I'm fixing to go down to Mexico. To see Alice in Nogales.
Thanks, folks. We'll see you soon.
Thank you, and I want to thank these guys up here for letting me come up here and pick with them. I really appreciate it, boys.
Our pleasure, Dickie Brown. Thank you, sir.
Sonoran Dogs, everybody. Aren't they great? What a treat. What a treat. Great band.